Thank you, Jesus. Lord, there's some saints here tonight who have a call on their lives, and they kind of stumbled. But I know one thing. You prophesied that your love is unconditional for them as long as they're alive. And your call on their life stays vibrant as long as they're alive. You called them years ago and they backslid. You called them years ago and they married somebody they should never have married, and they were emotionally scarred for the rest of their lives. They got involved with a church they should have never gotten involved with, and they picked up rejection. And they were hurt and they were wounded. They panicked like some of the people on Paul's ship. They were panicking. Some of them were trying to cheat and get in a lifeboat. You called them years ago, Lord, but the devil gently blew on them, and then he sent them a hurricane. They drifted off course. But they don't know. Your call is still vibrant, just like your love. And you didn't pull the call. They drifted away from it. You didn't reject them. They slowly left the port. The wind was blowing slowly. And then the hurricane. Yes. And I'm asking you, I'm claiming their call tonight. I'm claiming it back for them. I don't care who they married. I don't care who they broke up with. I don't care when they got divorced. I don't care how sick they were. I don't care how hurt they were. I don't care about any of it. All I care about is restoration. Restoration. Restoration is all you care about, Lord. Several people raised their hands when I asked them if they had call of God on their lives. Several people did. About half of them didn't. Well, that's okay. Again, calls come at different times in different places. Not everybody gets a call at the same time, at the same age. Everything's different. But some of the people that raised their hand drifted away. They got on the wrong ship. Oh, no. Well, Brother Mike, I'm discouraged. I'm down. I wasted so many years. I can't believe it. I understand. Would you repent of it and let God renew your call?
Yes.
Would you do that? You got into some crappy sins. You hurt yourself, you hurt somebody else. Okay. There's only one unpardonable sin. None of that stuff's unpardonable. Everything I just said is forgivable. There's only one unpardonable sin. It's too horrible to even mention. There's only one. That's it. The rest of it can be covered by the blood of Christ. And as a born-again Christian, when you backslid, you picked up demons. That's when they get in. They just rush in when you backslide. You go back to using, drinking, drugs, sex, porn, boop, the demons just jump right back in. You know why? Because the person who's given much, much is required. If you're a sinner and you do something, that's bad. If you're a Christian and you do the same thing, that's worse. Porn is bad for sinners. It's worse for Christians. It's worse. All that stuff will stall your call. And you can unstall it here, tonight. Did you backslide? You come down here right now and you'll be restored. Completely restored. Did you lose your call? You come down here for prayer and God will restore you. Did you waste your life? Yeah, sure did. You got involved with somebody you shouldn't even have talked to. You got involved in a system you shouldn't even have had a thing to do with. You started taking medication you should never even taken one of them pills. And something happened to you, and you need to be restored. This is the place to do it. This is the place to do it. Brother Mike, if I could give anything, I'd go back in my time past, and I wouldn't do this, I wouldn't say that, I wouldn't talk to that person, I wouldn't marry that person. Yeah, everybody has regrets. 100% of people have regrets. But not 100% of the people allow those regrets to destroy their spiritual life. Not everybody does that. Some people will repent. Will you repent of it? You ruined your marriage. You ruined your finances. You ruined everything. It can all be restored. It can be restored. If you'll repent. The guys on the ship repented and they believed Paul and they did what he said. They didn't at the beginning. And their lives were saved. Will you repent of it? Yes, you will. You know what? Because you got the call of God in your life, you want to restore it. God's called you to something. What is that? It's none of my business. None of my business what you've been called for. That's between you and the Lord. And you've already gone down with the ship. You know how them guys felt. You've already wasted decades of your life. It's gone. You cannot waste another hour. Not another hour. The devil wants to code blue you like he done my girl. He wants to code blue you. That's what he's looking to do. And I say, no way. No way. That's not going to happen. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, I wasted so much. I don't want to be code blue. I want to be restored. Dear God, forgive me. Brother Mike tried. I've been called. I drifted off like those sailors. Now I want to come home. And I know the love of God will save me because it's unconditional. No matter what I did, I am still loved. Please help me, Lord. I backslid years ago when I picked up spirits. It was my fault. I sinned. I fell in love with somebody and I kept committing adultery. I got involved in a business and cheated and lied. I did things for money I should have never done. God, have mercy on my soul. Please forgive me. I blame my spouse for everything, for ruining our marriage. And I forgot of all the things I did to ruin it. Please have mercy on me. Brother Mike's right, I got character flaws. I talk too much. I'm too insecure. I tell people what to do. I try to control other people. I know that's based on fear. I know that's low self-esteem. I'm asking you to save me, Lord.
Save me, Lord.
Please forgive me, Lord Jesus. I know I have the anointing to drive these backslider demons out. I know I can do it right now. The Bible says I can. I know I can do it. And I'm going to do it right this second. If you're married, I command every demon that transferred into your body from your spouse or your ex-spouse to be bound right now in the name of Jesus and to come out. And to come out. Every spirit from your wife, your husband, your ex-wife, your ex, whatever it is, you come out in the name of Jesus. You were on alcohol and drugs when you backslid and you picked up those spirits. You filthy devil, of you unclean spirit of addiction, I'm binding you right now. The Holy Ghost starting to move. I'm binding you right this second, right this moment. You got religious pride and religious arrogance, and you're always quoting scriptures, and you're telling people what to do and how to do it, when in fact you should have been doing it to yourself. They see you as a hypocrite. They look at you as a hypocrite. Satan, come out right now in Jesus' holy name. There he goes. Yawn them out. There they come. If you see somebody yawning, those are spirits coming out. If you see somebody coughing, those are spirits coming out. Spirit, I command you in the name of Jesus. You got to take authority over them. YouTubers, listen to me. Put your hand on your chest or your tummy. Put your hands on your sternum right there. Fear demons hang out in the torso area. Put your hand down there. Lust demons. Lust demons hang out in the torso and the groin. Lust demons. Alcohol, drugs, sex, porn. Put your hand on your body, YouTubers. In Jesus' holy name. I command you to come out of my body right this second. Rejection. Low self-esteem. Self-hatred. You spirit of rejection, I command you in the name of the Lord. I'm taking authority over you. The demon that causes me to talk all the time. Blah, 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 blah. That spirit of confusion, I command you to come out. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Remo Shandravasha Deva. Lendo Mosha Dreve. Koya Moshe Drasa. Koya Moshe Vivia. Dondre Moshava. Jesus' holy name. Come out of here, you pervert. Out of that body right now. Come out in Jesus' name. Come out in Jesus' name. Get out of that body right now. Go. Come out of there, you backslider. Come out, you stinking backslider. Hold that. Come out right now. Go, you backslider. Come out of that body in Jesus' holy name. Come out in the name of the Lord. Right now, quickly. Right now, quickly. Hurry up. Satan, loose your hold. Satan, loose your hold of my body. Loose your hold of my body. Alcohol. You demon of alcohol, I curse you. You cigarette spirit. You spirit of addiction. Come out of my body. You junk food devil. Eating garbage and trash all the time. I bind your power. I'm not getting diabetes. I am not getting that girl there. I'm not getting high blood pressure. I'm not getting diabetes. Come out of me right now. Do you hate yourself? Are you hard on yourself? You're going to end up with arthritis and fibromyalgia. Come out in Jesus' holy name. I command this pain to come out of my joints, my lumbar spine, my shoulders, in the name of the Lord. Come out right now in Jesus' holy name. Get out of that body. Come out of there right now, you mental illness demon. Come out as she commands you to go. Tell him to go. Right now, come out in Jesus' holy name. Come out in Jesus' name. Satan, I command you to loose my body right now. Come out of there right now. You stinking food demon, you're not giving me a heart attack? No. No heart attack. No. Come out right now. I command you to come out. Get out of my body right this second. Hurry up. Come out of there right now. Hurry up. Get out of that body right now. Hurry up. Come out of that body right now. You masturbating fool. Come out of that body right now. Spirit, come out. Lust, come out. There it comes. Lust, come out of that body. There he comes. Come out of there right now in Jesus' holy name. Just repent of it. Just repent of it. Here's how you repent. Lord Jesus, I'm sorry for what I did. I'm sorry for what I did. Please forgive me. I hurt myself. I hurt my kids. I hurt my wife. I hurt my husband. I hurt my boss. I lied. I cheated. Just confess it. If you confess your sins, God is faithful and just to forgive your sins and to cleanse you from all unrighteousness. If you confess it, if you do nothing and you try to cover it up and you're too insecure to confess it, you go home a failure. You go home a loser. You go home with demons. You got to do something to get a miracle. You got to step up to get a miracle. You've got to take command. Behold, I give you power to tread on scorpions, serpents, and over all the power of the enemy. Nothing shall by any means hurt you. Nothing. Stand firm against the devil. There they go. Here they come. There they come. Just fight. Paul said to Timothy, I want you to fight. I want you to war a good warfare. You got to learn to fight. You can't just sit there and take whatever crap the devil gives you. You are not a crap collector. You can't just sit there and take it. You got to fight back. How do you do that? You use your authority. In the name of Jesus, the Son of God, I bind your power, Spirit, Matthew 18. I bind your power, and I take authority over you. Come out of there, you backsliding. Come out of there, you masturbator. Come out of there, porn. Go! Go right now. Get out of there. Pornography. I bind your power, pornography. The biggest plague on the planet Earth is not diseases or illnesses. It's Pornhub. Pornography. It's Pornhub. Number one disease in the entire planet. Pornography spreads demons faster than anything in the world except maybe shooting up heroin, taking fentanyl, smoking pot for hours. My suspicion is Pornhub is the biggest plague in history. Pornography lets demons into your body instantaneously. They just slide right in. Get out of that body right now and stop stealing his destiny. Come out of there quickly. Come out right now. Come out faster. Come out. Every demon from his dad. Boom. Come out right now. Quickly. Quickly. I let my dad go. I replace my dad with my heavenly father. Did you have a rotten dad? Is your dad all screwed up? Okay. We need to get rid of your dad tonight and release him to the Lord. Get out of that body, you stinking devil. Stop causing him to backslide. Stop destroying his destiny. Stop stealing his call from him. Stop it right now. Stop this hurting this man of God. Stop blocking his healing gift. Stop it. Come out right now. Quickly. Quickly. All demons are scum. They're all scum. And if you let them in your body, they will eventually give you a terminal illness. Where do you think autoimmune diseases come from? Where do you think they come from? They fall out of a tree? No. They call the autoimmune diseases come from people who hate themselves. At some point in their life, they hated themselves. They were hard on themselves. They criticized themselves. And guess what happened? The devil gave them an autoimmune disease. Once you get an autoimmune disease, you cannot medically be cured. It is incurable. You let this woman of God go right this second. Did you hear me? Come out of that body right now. Stop stalling. Come out of there quickly. Come out of there right now and stop blocking her healing gift. I'm supposed to be healing these people with these hands. Yeah, stop it right now. Come on. Here he is. Here he comes. Here he comes. Here he comes. Come on out. Come out of there. Quickly. Every spirit from every ugly man that ever touched her body and transferred in there, I command you, come out of there quickly. Come out right now. Open your mouth. Breathe out of your mouth. It'll come right out. Breathe out of your mouth. Come out of her lungs. Come out of them lungs. Come out right now. Satan, I bind your power. Come out of the woman of God. Come out of there right now. I relieve every spirit from every man who ever touched my body. From the time I was a teenager to this moment, every ugly man that ever touched me, go! All of them. Every broken relationship, every broken promise, everybody that used me, all the users, come out. Come out right now. All the users, come out, everybody. Let her go. Let her go. Every user ever touched me. Every user. Get out of that body right now. Come out right now. Come out there quicker. Come out quicker. Come out there quicker. Come out quickly. Come on, her tummy. Come out there right now. There they go. Keep coughing. Come out, devil. Come out there right now. Quickly. Come out. Hurry. 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 Get out of that body right now. You food demon, come out of there right now. I curse you. Thank you. Hold that. Come out right now. Go. Come out right now. Go. Come out of there. Come on out. Quickly. Come out of that body quickly. Come out of there. Hurry. Hurry up. Come out right now. Quickly. Get out of that body right now. Come out of there. Quickly let go of this man of God. Stop stalling his destiny. Go right now. DD, I curse you. Come out. Romo Shavava. DD, come out there right now. Stop ruining her life. Stop turning into her a total failure. Stop destroying her. Stop sending her sister to hurt her all the time. Come on, there, you pig. DD, you pig. Come out. DD, you pig. Come out. Come out of there right now. Come out of there. Come out, you monster. Come out of that spine. Come out. Legion, come out. Legion, go. Legion. Get out of that body right now. Come out. Come out of there right now. Quickly. Quickly. Quickly repent. Just repent of it. Quickly. Do it quickly. How do you do that? I'll teach you. Lord, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for what I've done. I turned my back on my sin. I turned my back on my sin. Come on. Come on. Come on. Is your anointing stalled? Come on now. Lord God, give your people back their tears. Give them back their tears. Come on now. Get out of that body right now. DD, come out. Come on, Satan. Get out of that body right now, Satan. Come on. Did you used to hate yourself? Did you hate yourself? You got to repent of it. That's a sin. You cannot hate yourself. That's the same as hating somebody else. That's the same as hating somebody else. You can't hate yourself. That's a sin. Repent of it right now. Oh God. Oh God, forgive me. God, forgive me. Help me, Lord. Help me, Lord. God, forgive me. DD, come out of that body right now. Did you ever get involved in witchcraft? Are you ever involved in witchcraft? If you did, you bought the farm. You destroyed your life. It's over. You need to get down here and repent now. Witchcraft is the worst thing in the world. Witchcraft, the worst thing there is. New Age. Were you involved in New Age? If you did, you hung yourself. Come down here and repent right now. New Age. Were you raised a Mormon, a Jehovah Witness? Were you involved in Native American spiritualism? Were you? Come down here and repent. Hurry up. Hurry up. Familiar spirits are the worst kind of demons. They're the worst ones. Familiar spirits can perform miracles. They mimic the Holy Spirit. They can pretend to be the Holy Ghost. Witchcraft, worst thing you can get involved in. New Age, worst thing you get involved in. Come down here and repent. Have you ever hated somebody? If you did, you committed suicide. If you hate somebody, whatever a man sows, that shall he also reap. You will be hated. If you hated somebody, it will boomerang on you, and you will be hated. Right now, maybe not. Later, no question. Whatever a man sows, that is what he also reaps. Did you hate? Did you get abused by your dad, your stepdad, your foster dad, your husband, your ex-husband? Did you get abused by a man, ladies? Hey, did you hate them at one time? That's exactly what the devil wanted you to do. That's why he sent some man to abuse you. That's why you got abused. So you would hate them. When you hated them, you bought the farm. You bought it. The demons have you by the throat. You must forgive. There is no choice. You have to do it. You got to do it. It's non-negotiable. You must forgive, period. Who's the number one person you have to forgive? Who is it? It's you. Yourself. You got to forgive yourself for marrying him, for marrying her, for quitting that job, for raising your kids. You got to repent of it. You got to forgive yourself. You got no choice. You must do it. You got to do it. If you don't, the devil will draw and quarter you. He will draw and quarter you. The devil doesn't play around with people. He don't play around with people. He's a butcher. He's a butcher. You can't have nothing to do with the devil. Nothing. He will kill you. He's a murderer. He steals. He kills people. He destroys lives. That's in his nature. That's his nature. Repentance is your only hope. There is no other. You must repent of your sins. Thus saith the Lord. Repent and believe the gospel. Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Repent and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out, so the times of refreshing will come from the presence of the Lord. You must repent first before you get the benefits. You got to repent first. You got to go first. When God plays checkers, you don't move checkers at the same time. You got to go first. Then he moves. You move, then he moves. He's not going to move your. You got to move yours. Come on, folks. This isn't NASA. This isn't nuclear fission. Okay. This is the simplicity of Christ. You go first. Then he goes. You move first. Then he moves. What's the name of that guy? What's your husband's name? What's his name?
Carlos.
Carlos? All right. Dear Lord Jesus, pray after me. Dear Lord Jesus, you understand me? Say it out loud. Dear Lord Jesus, say it. I pray for Carlos right now. Is he alive? Is he alive? I pray for Carlos right now. I ask you to forgive him for beating me, for raping me. I ask you to forgive him for torturing me and abandoning me. And I forgive him. I forgive. I forgive. And I release Carlos. I release him from my soul. Now, and all his vicious demons, all of them, I release them now. Carlos, come out. Carlos, come out. Carlos, come out. Suelta, come out right now. Vamos. Suelta, come out right now. Carlos, come out of that body right now, you rapist. Come out of that body right now. There he comes, coming out right now. Here he comes. That woman was viciously abused by her husband. He beat her. He raped her. He abandoned her. He left her with nothing. He put her in the hospital. But tonight, we are going to forgive Carlos. We're going to forgive him because the Spirit of the Lord told us to. The Lord told us to do it. We don't ask any questions. We just do it. If you will not forgive your brother their trespasses, neither will your heavenly Father forgive you. You will not be forgiven. You will be turned over to the tormentors. Come on now. The only way you can be saved is if you forgive. Carlos, come out. Carlos tortured this woman. He tortured her. Tonight, we're all forgiving Carlos. Carlos, be forgiven in Jesus' name. We forgive you in Jesus' name. Lord, I ask you to go save Carlos. Go get him. Go get him. Go get him. Carlos, demons are coming out of this poor woman. He beat her. He raped her. He put her in the hospital multiple times. Where sin does abound, grace does that much more abound. No matter what sin you committed, if you repent, you will be forgiven by the blood of Jesus, the Son of God. Come out, Carlos. Come out in Jesus' holy name. Carlos, come out. This woman's getting a miracle from God right now. Do you want a miracle? Come up and take it. You got to take it. Come now. Let us reason together, saith the Lord. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be white as snow. Though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool. Have you not known? Have you not heard the Lord, the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary? There is no searching of his understanding, for he gives power to the faint, and those who have no strength, he increases their might. Even the young men shall be weary, the youth, they shall utterly fall, but they that wait upon the Lord, they shall renew. They shall be renewed. They will walk and not be weary. They will run. They will not faint. Hear the word of the Lord. My ways are not your ways. My thoughts are not your thoughts. For as heaven is high above the earth, so is my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts higher than your thoughts. As the rain and the snow come down and never return, so shall my word be that goes forth out of my mouth, saith the Lord. It will not return to me void, and it shall prosper in the thing where I sent it. Hear the word of the Lord. If thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, and keep his commandments, and follow his precepts, I will put none of these diseases upon you. I put on the Egyptians, for I am Yahweh Rapha. I am the eternal God who heals you. I am the God who heals you. Yahweh Rapha. I am the eternal God who heals you. Just repent of it. Thus saith the Lord. Your righteousness is like filthy rags in the sight of the Lord. The prophet Isaiah said, your righteousness is like filthy rags. Do you know what those filthy rags were in the Old Testament? Menstrual rags. Dirty, filthy menstrual rags. That is my righteousness in the eyes of God. Dirty, filthy, stinking tampons. That is your righteousness in the eyes of God. But we don't come in tonight with the righteousness of me or you. I come in with the righteousness of God in Christ. I receive the righteousness of God in Christ. I don't have any dirty used tampons. I have the righteousness of God in Christ. We don't have a menstrual blood. We got the blood of the Son of God. Not just covering sin. No, not good enough. I don't need an atonement. I need my sin removed. I don't get saved with the blood of bulls and goats, but with the precious blood of Christ, a lamb without a spot or a blemish. Filthy rags, no. The righteousness of God in Christ, yes. Come on. Just repent of it. YouTubers, get on your knees. Cry your eyes out. Thus saith the Lord. The Lord is nigh unto those who have a broken heart. He saves those who have a contrite spirit. That's what King David said. King David was right. King David was right. The Lord is nigh unto them who have a broken heart. Those who have a contrite spirit. Arrogance. Know-it-all. Bible thumpers. Those kind of people get nothing from God. You can be quoting the Bible till the cows come home. It isn't going to do you any good. You got to have a humble heart, a broken heart. That gets miracles from God. Ask the woman with the issue of blood. Ask blind Bartimaeus if you don't believe me. Ask the two blind men if you don't believe me. Ask a dying leper if you don't believe me. A broken heart moves the hand of God. A humble heart moves the Holy Ghost, the one and only. Humble yourselves under the mighty hand of God. He will exalt you in due time, says the Lord. Humble yourself. Come on now. Do you need to speak in tongues? You don't speak in tongues. Come down here so you can get your gift of tongues. It's very difficult to do spiritual warfare if you don't have a solid gift of tongues. Okay? If your tongues is like you're saying the same phrase over and over, that's what I call blocked tongues. You got blocked tongues. How are you doing on your tongues? Can you speak in tongues? Okay, just pray after me. It's easy. Boya basha. Kemo satia. Bekoba. Andoria. See, you're repeating it perfectly. Notice that? Now just do it by faith. Any syllable. Keyo mashava. Basha menti. Elo basata. Here, raise your hands. Thank you. Allah bashimini vava. Kura mashanda. Speak it out. Kora shama shama siva. That a girl. Just like that. Your tongues. Yeah, come on over here. Did you speak in tongues?
I get like stuck in the same word over and over.
Oh yeah, that's blocked. Okay, that's easy to fix. Okay. Now just pray after me. Ready? Moya masa. Beko masia. Alulia. Bashushi. Notice how easily you were repeating that? You notice that? Did you notice I was using different syllables, not the same ones? Like English, I'm using different syllables right now. The Greek word is glossa. Glossa is the same. You're using different syllables. See? So you do. Let's do it again. Ready? And this time you add different syllables on your own. Ready? Koya basha belo masite. Just like that. Good girl. There you go. Are you speaking it out? Louder. Good, just like this. Different switch. Good girl. Good girl. Switch it. She's starting right there. Here. You switch syllables. Ready? Koya mashavashita. Say that. Ola mashandro moshandre moshandarava. Ora vashandaravashite rebebe. Good. Thank you, Jesus. Holy Ghost, Lord. Touch her right now. Lord, I want you to go back in her childhood when she was scared as a kid. I want you to cast that fear demon out of there. Anxiety, I'm finding your power. You let this beautiful woman of God go. Good girl, now. There it is. That's the Holy Ghost. He's on you right now. Thank you, Jesus. It's happening. See that? You see her? You do that. Just speak out by faith. There you go, right there. Thank you, Jesus. Heal. There it is. There it is coming out right now. See that? See that? Here, speak like her. Keep going. Louder. There you go. She just got her gift of tongues. See her speaking right now? There you go. Good girl. Good. You switch syllables just like that. What you do is you get them to start, and then you teach them. You just give them a phrase, moya masa. Then they repeat it, and then I go kelo masi, and they repeat it. See that? That's how I got her going. And then you have them do it again, only this time they add syllables on their own.
Right. Okay.
So I start them up again, moya mashiba. And then they add some syllables, and then it takes off. Now let's switch over to singing. You ready? You take the syllables and you put a little hum to them. You can kind of slow it down a little and then sing and put hum. Ready? Remo Shava Roshivuri. Sing it out. Ure Ula Oriviri. Good. Louder. Undemere Ula. Soon as you start speaking in tongues, then you got to sing in tongues, okay? Singing in tongues is the highest form of worship known to man. Singing, worshiping in English or Spanish, that's okay. Nothing wrong with that. But to go up a grade, you gotta sing in glossa. The Greek word is glossa. Come on, YouTubers. Listen to me. Demo shavero, ero rebo shaluva. Honore Vahula Orivia. Demons hate singing in tongues. It's like scratching a chalkboard when I was in second grade. My teacher, Karen Bullis, dropped the chalk and her long nails went over the chalkboard, and I cringed in my seat. It was torture. When you sing in tongues, you are torturing the demons. They hate it. Come on, do it. Pay them back. Sing it out. Come on, sweetie. Heal. Lord, I want you to use this beautiful woman to heal women's broken hearts. I want you to use these hands to do it. Heal. She's always wanted to do that, and that anxiety has been blocking her. anxiety, I curse you to fail. Come on. There it is right there. Let your tears go. There it is. That's the Holy Ghost touching you, honey. You're a very loved person. Just take it. Just take it. Once the Holy Ghost starts touching you, just go for it. Run on in. Don't stand there. Run in. Push it. Go for it. He's got gifts for you, miracles for you. He's got so much stuff, it's unbelievable. Atta girl, let your tears go. Come on, sweetheart. Come on, sweetie. What's going on?
I was sent here. God told me to come. And it was exact what I needed to hear. You were right on point. And I've been doing really, really well.
What's left? What's left? Come out.
I had an issue a few weeks ago.
What is it?
My hands were hurting me very badly.
Come out.
But it got to the point where I was crying out to God. I mean, literally.
Oh, good.
They were hurting so bad. They feel good right now.
Good.
But I went and I did marijuana gummies. I went and I got marijuana gummies because I know those work.
Yeah.
And they take the edge off. I wasn't trying to do anything else but take the edge off.
Yeah.
I went through probably the most scary experience of my life. I was literally feeling myself fade in and out.
Yeah.
Come out. I immediately grabbed my headphones, put Christian music on because it was like, that's the only thing I was going to say. And I literally got, Jesus, get me out of here.
Now, when did that first start? What age?
This has been years.
Well,
years.
How old are you now?
Years.
Okay.
And this has been for years.
So that's from repetitive use syndrome?
Yeah.
Like carpal tunnel or
like
something?
Carpal tunnel. Okay. But right now they feel good.
You okay.
Know, I mean, they're not perfect, but they feel good.
Did they feel better than this morning?
Yeah.
How about yesterday?
Yep.
Okay. Now listen, that's an indication, that's a spirit in there. Okay? Because it ebbs and flows. If it was carpal tunnel, that's a medical condition.
Right.
And that doesn't go away.
Well, if I go work out, they feel better. Mm.
Yeah, because you're loosening them up and stretching them out.
Right,
but if you just spontaneously felt better, that sounds like a spirit of infirmity.
Actually, there, some stuff did come up.
You speak in tongues?
Coughing.
You speak in tongues?
Hmm?
You speak in tongues?
I do.
Yeah, come on over here. Can you help her? Yeah, go ahead. Speak it out. And don't touch her, but just speak it out. Oh, come on now. It's blocked. That's blocked. Come on now. Just repeat after me. Kelo masa. Speak it out. Uh-oh. The demons are blocking your tongues. That we can't have that. What's wrong with you?
I came here 2 weeks ago. You weren't here.
Oh.
I've been doing was here. And I was with the cane. Because I had a broken ankle from a year and a half ago. And ever since I left your temple here, I've never used a cane anymore.
You throw your cane away?
It's there, but I haven't used it for 2 weeks already.
What was hurting on your body?
I have a metal rod from my knee to my heel.
You got a metal rod down there?
Yeah.
Does it still hurt?
No.
It all went away? Thank you, Jesus.
See?
Great.
Yeah, 2 weeks ago,
Jesus. Yay! You got your leg healed? Okay. Now what else isn't healed?
Also my heart.
What's wrong with your heart?
I was 10 years ago.
Come on, Burra Masha.
We had 5 years left, and it's been 11 years.
What's the diagnosis?
Congestive heart failure.
Congestive heart failure.
And it went from being only 20% working.
See? Stay straight.
Is it all healed up now?
Yes, it is.
Oh, is there anything that's not healed?
Stay straight.
Right now, I'm going to just the strength. Just to keep losing weight.
Oh, losing weight. Why are you heavy? What's causing that? Okay, speak it out loud. Koya Mashava. Just repeat after me. Boya Baba. Stay here. Stay here.
Thank you.
Now stay right here. Ura Masha. Hey, now that demon's blocking your tongues. Just repeat after me. Koya Mashava.
Koya Mashava.
Kelo Satia.
Kelo
Bekoba. Good. Now you add some syllables on your own. Ready? Ola mashava. Velo shinti mebu. Any syllable, there's no wrong answer. Endomushandravashite. Endomushatafa. Good, that's much better. Ekumushandravaseva. Syllables. Kurasha viveva. Gundra, you rotten devil, I command, I'm going to count to three. You stop blocking him. One, two, three. Come out of there. Stop blocking that. Duna Moshandra Moshe Vefa. Speak it out. And you're losing weight. Why? What's wrong with your weight?
I'm losing weight to continue the journey.
You can continue to what?
You know, our body's our temple.
But why are you heavy?
I was fasting.
Say it.
I was fasting backwards instead of doing it, you know, throughout the night. I was just flip-flop because of my job.
Oh, your job.
So because I was basically that night eating, not eating at work, but when I would get home, I was just wanting to eat a horse. And now I'm not doing that anymore.
Oh, okay.
I'm not doing that anymore.
Yeah, don't fast anymore. Hey, speak it out. Kola masha veva. Ora masite va. Syllables. Use syllables.
Ora. Thank God that you brought me to YouTube today.
Yeah. Hold on a second. Honey, how are you doing? How'd that go? Were you singing in tongues? Had a girl. All right. Now, hold on a minute. I got to give you something. Okay? I got to give you something before you leave. Yeah. What was that?
She's the one that brought me here, too.
You brought him here? Okay. Now, what is needed here?
What is needed?
Yeah, for him to lose weight. What's needed? Speak it out. You're not speaking. Stop it. Stop blocking his tongues. Ashumasa. Woshamasi. Just like that. Any syllable. Undremosa vashata. He's got demons in his brain, and they're blocking him from speaking. See that? He's trying to do it, but they're blocked. They got a stranglehold on him. Okay? So I'm trying to encourage him to step out in faith and just repeat a syllable or two. Yeah, slower. Just repeat it out. Attica. Thank you, Jesus. All right. Lord, I want you to bless this brother right now. You got a call on his life. You got something you want him to do. And he's had a difficult life. And every one of those challenges and difficulties, you're going to turn into an asset for him. All those bad things that happened, all the disappointments and all the people that let him down. All of it. The deep sadness from his youth. Rejection. Disappointments. People that said they'd help him and didn't. They backed out. Every single one of them that hurt him. Every one of them. All that time when he went to school as a kid, bullied in school. I want you to forgive all them bullies. They didn't like him. And we forgive him today. We ask you to forgive him. Amen. Love you.
Love you too.
Boy, come on now, let's go. This is ridiculous. Koyamasha. Just repeat after me. Koyamasha. Good, you did it. Beo baba. Koyasime. Bakoba. There you go. Now you add some syllables on your own. Demosha dramosha beveshe se. Koyamasibe. Any syllable. Good. See, there you go. Good. Good, good, good. He's got spirits in his brain. This guy does. And they shut. See, they literally shut you up. That's how strong they are. See, and he's trying to fight through it here. No, and he still, don't try to memorize anything. Just release it. Just relax and release. Don't memorize it. Koyamasaba.
Huh? It just poured out. I don't know why.
No, they're blocking you. Now just close your eyes and relax. You see, you're all tensed up. See, it's hard to release your tongues if you're all tensed up. So while you try, I try to get them to relax. Sometimes I even go like that, just get them to stop, because they're kind of tense. See,
yeah,
you got a little of that in there. There's a little anxiety in them. Just there you go. Big breath and relax, and then release. There you go. Come on out, devils. Come on out, spirit. There they go. See the anointing healing? See that? Speak it out. Good. Good. Good, good, good. Andre Mosha Vive Vasa. Ati Mosha Dremog. Any syllable. There's no wrong answer, so you can't be. You're not wrong. There's no way to be wrong. Good. That's perfect. That's perfect. YouTubers, listen to me. This is Brother Mike. Listen, are you shipwrecked? Yeah. Listen. You swim to shore, man. Leap off that boat by faith and swim to shore. Go to the website, hardcorechristianity.com. I need you to read two articles. Go to the teaching button at the top. You got to read the article, How Satan Controls the Mind. You got to read the other article, Satan's Counterattack. You will be hit within 48 hours of this service. You're going to be hit and hit hard. YouTubers, if you are mentally ill, it will not be 48 hours. It'll probably be 4 hours. It will be later tonight. It could be a dream. It could be a nightmare. It could be some stupid thought popping into your head. You're going to get hit within a few hours. If you are not mentally ill, you will be hit within 48 hours of this service. They're going to try to steal everything you learned and everything you received from the Lord. That's their job. They steal, they kill, they destroy. All right. Please remember our Zoom service for the ladies on Monday. Monday nights at 6:30 p.m. Pacific time. Please remember our other Zoom services, Wednesday and Saturday at 6 p.m. Pacific time. We have two live services every week. Please check out our YouTube channel. We broadcast them live. Thursday night, Brother Rick is here and he kills it. You cannot miss that Thursday night service with Brother Rick. 7 p.m. Pacific time on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/houseofhealingaz. Hey, we'll see you next time.